nature. It's really amazing. Planets, the elements, wind, water, life and death. Unpredictable, yet somehow in balance, just like life. You know, as a young kid, I loved academics and the arts. I didn't really have a physical side. Things were out of balance. And I guess, somehow by instinct, I searched out a sport that put emphasis on the physical side of me, and I found martial arts and karate. Now, as I became more proficient, I realized that physical fitness was extremely important in order for people to realize their full potential in any part of their lives. Physical fitness has surely brought balance to my life. The body, it's a highly specialized, hard-working machine. If you don't keep it serviced and tuned, there is no way it will function the way you want it to. I've seen so many people striving to achieve their goals and then just fall short, not because they didn't deserve the success or because they weren't smart enough, but because their bodies didn't have the endurance it takes to succeed. I found it very sad because I knew that if they'd only worked out and stayed healthy, they'd reach their maximum potential. Sections of my workout. Warm up, to raise the body temperature and loosen up the muscles. Cardiovascular section, to work your heart, lungs, and circulatory system. Body sculpting, to reshape our body, building muscular definition and strength. Stretching, to lengthen the muscles and prevent soreness and injury. Stress management, to, in a physical way, deal with a very serious threat to our health. All you need is some floor space, good ventilation, some water nearby, and a jump rope if you have it. You also need workout clothes and gym shoes with a soft sole. I'll give you advice on using additional equipment as we move along. Now adapt this program to your own personal level. When you're ready, let's do it and go to work. The purpose of the warm-up is not only to stretch the muscles and ligaments, but also to gradually speed up the body metabolism. We'll start with the neck and move down the body. All movements should be slow and deliberate. Concentrate on your muscles. Now slowly stretch your neck muscles by tipping your head completely forward and back. Don't force it. Now change your movement, go side to side. And circles. One way and then back the other way. Great, now let's work the shoulders. Shoulder shrugs backwards. Go back. That's it, take your time, and then forwards, feel those muscles. Now let's swing those arms around. Stretch your shoulders, your chest, and your back. Let's continue stretching the chest and back in this way. And the other side. Clasp both hands behind your back and stretch your chest. And stretch your back this way. Now let's work the side abdominals. Side bends. Give it a good stretch. Let's try some trunk rotations to the right and switch and go around. Work your hips, work your abdominal area. Now trunk twists. Stretch that lower back and stretch that waist. Put your hands on your hips and push forward. That's it. Feet slightly apart, then push. Push to the side. Now let's work the quadriceps. Grab your foot with your hand and stretch. Feel it right down the front of your thigh. Now the other leg. If you have problems with your balance, use a chair. Now let's work the hamstrings. Feet apart and bend forward. Stretch. Keep your legs slightly bent. Place your feet a little further apart with your hands on your legs just above the knee. Let's work the inner thigh with some stretch squats. Keep your back straight and squat down. It's a very slow and deliberate movement. Now let's work the calves. Right leg forward and bend down. Left leg forward and stretch. Very good. Now stand up, take a deep breath. Let's work your heart, lungs, and circulatory system. Four rounds of a boxer's workout. Let's start with shadow boxing, round one. That's it, move in place, come on, move. Dance around like a fighter. Shift your weight back and forth, back and forth. That's it. Try a few jabs. That's it, jab. And try a few combinations. Left, right, left, right.
Don't judge by what you see. There's a soft part of me.
You can also use an exercise bike, you can use a rowing machine, or you can just jog in place, anything. Just keep moving. That's the important thing now, okay?
I was the one who loved you long ago. Do you
There's a glow you recognize.
This tape is designed as a progressive workout to be used for a period of time by people of various fitness levels. It's very simple. Just follow the exercises until you get tired and then rest until the next round starts. Are you ready for round two? Now let's speed it up and jump some rope. It's fun, okay? Skipping rope is more strenuous than you think. It takes little space and is a very effective exercise.
My life changed that day you told me, dearest world, you'd better be moving on. So you found a true man, not a blue man who gets you what you want. Someday, I keep telling you, someday.
Rope skipping is great for your coordination, your stamina, your legs, your calves, everything.
I can't forget those diamond blue eyes. Reach out and grab me and haunt me in the night. Well, you can't tell me you didn't love me. I've seen it in your eyes.
Oh boy, I'm taking a break. How about you? Huh? You gonna go on? All right, sure.
It's gonna break, oh no, away from me.
Now round three, let's try some wind sprints. Are you ready? Go! Run in place. Pick those knees up. That's it. Now wear some running shoes, okay? Go! Pick them up. Pick them up. That's it. Go! That's it. Jog in place now, okay? Take deep breaths and shake it loose. Running is great for you. It works your entire body, but if you run outside, avoid hard surfaces, okay? And please remember, wear good running shoes. Ready for a second dash? Go! Pick those knees up. All right, pick them up. And stretch out. That's it. Push it, push it, push it. All right. Oh, good job. Cool out, jog in place, keep moving, shake loose. One more dash left now. Okay, just remember to keep your knees up. Pick those knees up, okay? Last dash. Ready? Go. Remember to pick knees up. Come on. Great. And here they are, ladies and gentlemen, out for the final round, and there goes the bell. seconds. Keep moving. Come on, keep moving. 25, 23. Right hand, left hand. Right hand. Come on, keep punching, please. Keep punching. 15 seconds left. 14, 13. The crowd is standing. The crowd is standing. He's still in there, digging into the body. To the body. 6, 5, 4. He's working. 3, 2, 1, and that's it. Good work. Now let's take a water break. Relax, have some liquid, not too much, and keep your energy up. Michelangelo said that a beautiful body is the manifestation of a noble spirit. And look, the human body has fascinated every civilization throughout history. All societies have encouraged or enforced their members to maintain good health and bodies. So let's follow the example of the ancient Greeks and work on sculpting our own bodies for the next 20 minutes. Let's start with legs. Let's do some squats. Ready? 1, 2, move down parallel to the floor. 3, 4, keep your hands out in front of you. 5, 6, 7, that's it. 8, keep your back straight. 9, 10, we'll be doing 4 sets of these. 11, 12, 13, 14, and one more, 15. All right, take 10 seconds rest. Now, widen your stance, point your feet out, same hand position. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, parallel, 5, 6, this works the inner thigh, 7, 8, 9, keep going, 10, 11, 12, great, 13, come on, 2 more, 14, and 15. All right, back to the first narrow stance again. Shoulder width, toes forward. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, that's great. 4, remember, parallel to the floor and hands on your chest. Keep counting yourself now. In the following exercises, you may not be able to complete all the repetitions in each set. But don't worry, just gradually increase the number of reps each time you work out. That's what's called a progressive workout. Now give yourself time to build physical strength. Okay, back to wide stance again, the fourth and last set. Are you ready? 1, 2, keep going. That's it, great. Now you must work each set until you're tired, then rest and wait for the next freeze frame and join in the next set. Okay, so in this way, you can work harder and harder the stronger you get. And please concentrate, feel the muscles work. Focus your energy. Now, let's work some lunges. Keep your legs shoulder width apart. Are you ready? Lunge out. 1, 2. And right, alternating your legs. And left. And right. We'll do 16 of these, 8 each leg. Left. Great. Keep your movement smooth. Don't jerk. Down. Don't bounce. Down. This is a great exercise for a typical problem spot for women, which is the back of the thigh and the back of the buttocks. That's it, great. And one more. And one more. We're doing 4 sets of these, so take 10 seconds off between sets. Are you ready? Second set. 1, two, three, four, stretch out, five, keep your hands on your hips, six, seven, great, good job. Good. Feel that stretch. Feel it. One more. And one more. Great. Try to focus when you do these exercises. Make sure that you concentrate on the muscle you're working. One. Third set, two, three, four. Come on, keep going. Come on, work those thighs. Burn that fat tissue. Great. Burn it up. Come on. Burn it up. Ready for the last set. This is the big one. Are you ready? One. Stretch out. Two. And back. Three. And back. Four, and back. Develop your calves, stand straight with your feet slightly apart. Toes out. Are you ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, up, seven, eight, nine, ten. Work those calves. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And now another set, toes in. Are you ready? This works the outer calf. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Third set, toes out again now. Are you ready? One, two, three, and four, and five. Come on, up. Work those calves. And ready for the fourth and last set. Toes in. And go. Two, three, four. Now let's work the upper body with some push-ups. We'll use five different hand positions. Let's start with normal grip, shoulder width. One, two, three, make sure your back and legs are straight. We'll do 15 of these in each set. Set to narrow grip. Ready? Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. This works the chest. 5, 6. Keep going. Legs straight, remember? Now third set, fingers pointed out. This'll work your triceps, the muscles in the back of your arm. 1, 2, 3, 4. Work those triceps. Great. Alright guys, let's try another position. Let's try with our fingers pointing in. This works the shoulders and the back better. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good job. Now last grip is wide. Are you ready to stretch that chest? Are you ready? 1. Stretch. 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 Last set now. Come on, work it. Feel a burn. Now time to torture our stomach and our abdominal muscles. Flip on your back and get ready for stomach crunches. You ready? 1, 2, 3, don't, 4, 5, don't reach too far. Don't lift your back off the floor. Just your shoulders, like that. Crunch that stomach, great. Don't jerk up, just curl up. That's it. Now, next set, we'll do leg lifts. Ready? One, two, three, four. Keep your hands under the small of your back. This works your lower abdominal area. Remember, don't let your feet touch the ground. That's it. Good. Now, time for exercise number 3, alternate sit-ups. Are you ready? One, two, three, and 4, and 5, and 6. This works the side of your abdominals. Curl. And curl. Great. Now one-legged sit-ups. Ready? Try to touch your ankle now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Left leg first. And 6, 7. And 8, 9, 10. Switch legs and do the same thing again. Ready, go. 2, 3. Good. Now time for some scissor crosses. This works your lower abdominal area. Ready? Extend your legs and go. 1, 2, 3. Crossover. 4. Great. 5. 6. Great. 7. Good. Keep going, come on, keep going. Keep it up. Now, let's work your waist again. Lay on your right side, one hand behind your neck. Ready? Bring that leg up. 2, 3, 4. Bring it up past the elbow. 5, 6. You can go on the outside or on the inside. Keep going. Work those sides. Contract. And contract. Change sides now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can alternate like inside, outside, inside, outside. Now roll on your stomach and we'll work your lower back. Your hands behind the small of your back. Ready for some hypers or hyperextensions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep your feet on the floor. 6, 7, 8. All the way up. 9. Look up. Keep your eyes up. Now move your hands behind your neck. Do the same thing again. Come on. Great. Great. Up. And up. Now some standing side bends to work the waist. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep going. This works your waist. A problem spot for men especially. Let's take care of those love handles, guys. The key here is high repetitions. Keep going, keep going. And side, and side, and side, and go. All right, now let's do some trunk twists. One, two, three, four, five, and keep going. Keep those hands out shoulder height. And twist, and twist, and twist. Go, go, go. You should feel this in the back of your waist. Great. Now let's take a break and check your heart rate. Use 2 fingers of your right hand to check your pulse. Ready to count. Go. Stop. Multiply the number of beats by 5 and get your working heart rate. For optimum training effect, it should fall within the target heart rate in the diagram shown here. If your working heart rate is too high, please slow down. If it's too low, you haven't worked hard enough. But now take a break. Relax, have some water, and look at what you did. At After every workout, it is always important to stretch. It'll help your muscles from tightening up, reduce soreness, and increase your flexibility. Let's go through a short stretching routine. Since we've been through most of these stretches in the warm-up, I'll let the pictures guide you. Remember, each movement is slow and deliberate. Don't bounce and concentrate on your muscles. While you work, I'd like to talk to you about something very important. To stay in shape, you have to do more than exercise. As I mentioned earlier, the human body is like a machine. It needs the right fuel at the right time and in the right amount. If I give you an idea of how I eat during an average day, maybe it'll help you plan your own nutrition better. My breakfast varies a lot depending on my schedule. If I'm gonna work out first thing in the morning, maybe I'll have some fruit like banana or orange, just to get the blood sugar going, you know? Your blood sugar is lower at night than it is during the day, so you gotta get a little kick before you work out. Say, I gotta take care of some business first, then maybe I'll have a little heavier breakfast, like some bread, some bran muffin with a bit of honey, or maybe cereal. I usually use apple juice instead of milk. It has more carbohydrates and, you know, I just like the taste, that's it. Also, maybe I'll have half a cup of coffee or something. Sometimes I'll have hot cereal, but usually I try to avoid the added salt, butter, and sugar. If I really need a big breakfast, I'll go for eggs. And usually I eat them minus the yolk, because the yolk is where most of the fat and cholesterol is stored. Basically, you want to go for carbohydrates before working out and for protein afterwards. Protein are things like fish, chicken, red meat, veal, eggs, so forth. Carbohydrates are bread, muffin, cereal, pasta, rice, potatoes. I make lunch my biggest meal. I usually eat fish, chicken, a salad, and maybe a complex carbohydrate like rice or potatoes or pasta. Also, I like vegetables a lot, because they're a good source of fiber and they have a lot of vitamins, especially the dark green ones. A good rule of thumb for eating throughout the day is basically to decrease your carbohydrate intake and increase your protein intake as the day progresses. I basically start the day with carbs and end it with protein at dinner. Now, if I'm gonna cheat and have a piece of cheesecake or whatever, I'll have it at lunch, or maybe for breakfast. Ice cream for breakfast, right? Now, how about snacks? Well, basically, I like simple carbohydrates like fruit, granola, muffins, or bananas are real good because they have a lot of potassium, which keeps you from getting muscle cramps and decreases your sodium intake. You know, sodium retains water in your body and also raises your blood pressure. I try to use honey to replace sugar. Once I got away from salt and sugar and other heavy spices, I found I didn't even miss them. And how about liquids? Well, our bodies are 80% water, so water is definitely very important. I try to drink bottled water if I can because it has less sodium, and water generally flushes your system out and helps your complexion a lot. Fruit juices are good, but watch the calories. And if you think about it, a big glass of orange juice is like about 4 oranges. I know a pal of mine who went on a fruit juice diet and actually gained about 10 pounds, right? So take it easy.
Yeah!
Okay, where are we here? Working a chest. Are you doing okay? You've been concentrating, focusing on your muscles, and doing each movement slowly and deliberately, right? Good. Okay, well, shake loose. Great. Your head, side to side. Good. Okay, you feel good, huh? Relaxed. Move. Great. Good job. Again, good job. Oh, I feel it's really important when I'm working hard to take a few minutes each day to relax, to center, and try to refocus myself. The intensity of modern life, the constant flow of information, personal relationships, career pressures, making it, being somebody, overachieving to live the high technology lifestyle.
It's your life and you can take control of it. It's up to you.
Here are a few simple exercises I use to relieve stress. Okay guys, let's start with a slow, comfortable head roll in clockwise motion. All right, great. Slowly go around, relax. This will work out tension in your neck muscles and in your head area. Great. Remember, sit with your back straight and your buttocks towards the back of your chair. Okay, let's try some shoulder shrugs. One, two, shoulders back, back. That's it. Relax. Relieve that tension. It's easy. Check it out. And now your pretty face. Let's relax your face, okay? Close your eyes, then open. Close, then open. Relax. And your jaw. Open, close. Open, close. How about some breathing? Take a breath in, hold it, and blow it out.
Now you should feel terrific, energized, relaxed, revitalized, and ready to make your fantasies come true. Now the key is, by realizing who you are and where you are now, there's absolutely nothing to stop you from going all the way. In other words, maximizing your potential.
Sometimes I ask myself, how many times have I done this? How many sit-ups, how many push-ups, how many times running early in the morning? Why am I doing all this? Is it really worth it? And how many more times will I have to do this to stay in shape and to maintain my lifestyle? But then I know that having the strength to work out gives me more strength. Strength to find what I'm looking for in life which is still a struggle. And like anything worth having in life, if you want to stay in shape, you have to work for it.
Hey, Joe.